Good evening. Welcome to Evening Prayer for Monday, 30th September 2024, 19th Sunday after Pentecost, Proper 21.
You are God in heaven, and here am I on earth. So I'll let my words be few. Jesus, I am so in love with you. Jesus, I am so in love with you. The simplest of love songs I want to bring to you. So I'll let my words.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Father, We come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover, had been sacrificed for us. So let us celebrate the feast, not with an old leaven of corruption and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, once raised from the dead, died no more. Death have no more dominion over him. In dying, he died to sin once for all. In living, he lives to God. See yourselves, therefore, as dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ had been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For as by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and so serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant, merciful Lord, to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins, and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Psalm 89, verse 19 to 52. You spoke once in a vision and said to your faithful people, I have set the crown upon a warrior and have exalted one chosen out of the people. I have found David, my servant, with my holy oil have I anointed him. My hand will hold him fast, and my arm will make him strong. No enemy shall receive him, nor any wicked man bring him down. I will crush his foes before him, and strike down those who hate him. My faithfulness and love shall be with him, and shall be victorious through my name. I will make his domain extend from the great sea to the river. He will say to me, you are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation. I will make him my firstborn, and higher than the kings of the earth. I will bring my love for him forever, and my covenant will stand firm for him. I will establish his line forever, and his throne as a dais of heaven. If his children forsake my law and do not walk according to my judgment, if they break my statutes and do not keep my commandments, I will punish their transgressions with a rod and their iniquities with a lash. But I will not take my love from him, nor let my faithfulness prove false. I will not break any covenant, nor change what has gone out of my lips. Once for all, I have sworn by my holiness, I will not lie to David. His line shall endure forever, and his throne as a son before me. It shall stand fast forevermore like the moon, the abiding witness in the sky. But you have cast off and rejected your anointed. You have become enraged at him. You have broken your covenant with your servant, defiled his crown, and hurled it to the ground. You have breached all his walls and laid his stronghold in ruins. All who pass by despoil him, and he has become the scorn of his right neighbors. You have exalted the right hand of his foes and made all his enemies rejoice. You have turned back the edge of his sword and have not sustained him in battle. You have put an end to his splendor and cast his throne to the ground. You have cut short the days of his youth and have covered him with shame. How long will you hide yourself, O Lord? Will you hide yourself forever? How long will your anger burn like fire? Remember, Lord, how short life is, how frail you have made all flesh. Who can live and not see death? Who can save himself from the power of the grave? Where, Lord, are your loving kindness of old, what you promised David in your faithfulness? Remember, Lord, how your servant is mocked, how I carry in my bosom the taunts of many peoples. The taunts your enemies have hurled, O Lord, which they hurled at the heels of your anointed. Blessed be the Lord forevermore. Amen. I say, Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be. Amen. First reading is taken from 2 Kings, chapter 17, verse 24-41. The king of Assyria brought people from Babylon, Kuta, Ava, Hamat, and Sepharvaim, and placed them in the cities of Samaria, in place of the people of Israel. They took possession of Samaria and settled in its cities. When they first settled there, they did not worship the Lord. Therefore the Lord sent lions among them, which killed some of them. So the king of Assyria was told, "The nations that you have carried away and placed in the cities of Samaria do not know the law of the God of the land. Therefore, he has sent lions among them. They are killing them because they do not know the law of the God of the land." Then the king of Assyria commanded send there one of the priests whom you carried away from there. Let him go and live there, and teach them the law of the God of the land. So one of the priests whom they had carried away from Samaria came and lived in Bethel. He taught them how they should worship the Lord. But every nation still made gods of its own and put them in the shrines of the high places that the people of Samaria had made. Every nation in the cities in which they lived, the people of the Babylon made Succoth Benot. The people of Cuth made Negal. The people of Hamath made Ashemi. The Avites made Nebazo. And Tatek, the Shevites, burned their children in the fire to Adramalich and Anamelech, the gods of Sepharvaim. They also worshipped the Lord and appointed from among themselves all sorts of people as priests of the high places, who sacrificed for them in the shrines of the high places. So they worshipped the Lord, but they also served their own gods after the manner of the nations from among whom they had been carried away. To this day they continue to practice their former customs. They do not worship the Lord, and they do not follow the statutes or the ordinance of or the law or the commandments that the Lord commanded the children of Jacob, whom he named Israel. The Lord had made a covenant with them and commanded them, "You shall not worship other gods, or bow yourself to them, or serve them, or sacrifice to them. But you shall worship the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt with great power and with outstretched arm. You shall bow yourself to him, and to him you shall sacrifice." The statutes and the ordinance and the law of the commandment that he wrote to you, you shall always be careful to observe. You shall not worship other gods. You shall not forget the covenant that I have made with you. You shall not worship other gods, but you shall worship the Lord your God. He will deliver you out of the hand of all your enemies. They would not listen, however, but they continue to practice their former customs. So do these nations worship the Lord, but also serve their carved images. To this day, their children and their children's children continue to do as their ancestors did. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in you, O God, my Savior. For you have looked with favor on your lowly servant. From this day all generation will call me blessed. You, the Almighty, have done great things for me, and holy is your name. You have mercy on those who fear you from generation to generation. You have shown strength with your arm and scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their throne and lifting up the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things, and the rich you have sent away empty. You have come to the help of your servant Israel, for you have remembered your promise of mercy, the promise made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Second reading is taken from Acts chapter 20, verse 17 to 38. From Miletus, he sent a message to Ephesus, asking the elders of the church to meet him. When they came to him, he said to them, "You yourselves know how I lived among you the entire time, from the first day that I set foot in Asia, serving the Lord with all humility and with tears, enduring the trials that come to me through the plots of the Jews. I did not shrink from doing anything helpful, proclaiming the message to you and teaching you publicly and from house to house, as I testify to both Jews and the Greeks about repentance towards God and faith towards our Lord Jesus. And now, as a captive to the Spirit, I am on my way to Jerusalem, not knowing what will happen to me there, except that the Holy Spirit testifies to me in every city that imprisonment and persecution are waiting for me. But I do not count my life for any value to myself, if only I may finish my course and the ministry that I receive from the Lord Jesus, to testify to the good news of God's grace. And now I know that none of you, among whom I have gone about proclaiming the kingdom, will ever see my face again. Therefore, I declare to you this day that I am not responsible for the blood of any of you. For I did not shrink from declaring to you the whole purpose of God. Keep watch over yourselves and over all the flock, of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God, that he obtained with the blood of his own Son. I know that after I have gone, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock. Some even from your own group will come distorting the truth in order to entice and entice the disciples to follow them. Therefore, be alert, remembering that for 3 years I did not cease night or day to warn everyone with tears. And now I command you to God and to the message of his grace, a message that is able to build you up and to give you the inheritance among all who are sanctified. I converted no one's silver or gold or clothing. You know for yourself that I worked with my own hands to support myself and my companion. In all things I have given you an example that by such work you must support the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus. For he himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down with them all and prayed. There was such weeping among them all. They embraced Paul and kissed him, grieving, especially because of what he had said, that they would not see him again. Then they brought him to the ship. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word had been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servant with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. The Collect, Proper 21. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, support us all the day long of this troublous life, until the shade lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, Lord, in mercy grant us safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn but the sword of righteousness, no strength known but the strength of love, so mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all people may be gathered under the banner of the Prince of Peace, as children of one Father, to whom be dominion and glory, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, you have promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in your Son's name. We pray that what we have asked faithfully we may obtain effectively through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.